Yeah, Smart Wargames here. Let's check out Command Modern Operations, the Red Tide expansion. Really excited to check out again Command. Yeah, it's some time since we played that. And what is Red Tide? Red Tide is focusing on a Cold War gone hot situation between 75 and 85. It's somewhat the spiritual successor of Northern Fury, a really great community campaign pack which we already played here on my channel. There are quite some videos, and yeah, check it out. And yeah, what we will do, we will check out the content. First do a sound check.
It's somewhat the spiritual success.
Yeah, we'll do a content check. I will show you what you will get with this game, explain a bit then. We will go into the scenarios so you have an idea what to expect. At the same time, I will also check what changed. It is some time since I played Command. And then we will do some a bit gameplay. Yeah, probably play the first scenario of the campaign, as it seems to be a smaller scale action in the, yeah, depicting the casus belli, yeah, the reason why it is happening, why is the Cold War between the two major powers escalating. Good, let's check out the, there is a campaign mode. Yeah, I'm sometimes not decide on to play scenarios in campaign mode, or you can also play them simply in a successive manner by going here and play them. Yeah, normally in Command there's not that much progression between missions, there's nothing tracked. That would be great, of course, for future versions. I think I read somewhere on a roadmap that this might be planned, that something like forces might, or results might, change the outcome of a campaign. You could think something of like campaign trees, like in a combat mission. It is of course very difficult to achieve, especially taking the scale of Command into account, as it is operational warfare, or even strategic naval and air warfare. Almost strategic. So you can, and I sometimes played the campaign mode, got stuck somewhere and couldn't proceed because I lost the mission and had to replay it. Not really a big fan of replaying it. Not sure how the requirements are in this campaign, but keep in mind, you can play the campaign in this campaign mode, but you can also play those scenarios single by single and simply follow the path. Good. Yeah, we will start with the Bedford incident. I read on the page that this is the reason why they're going to war. Seems like a submarine incident, which is not too unlikely. And there were a lot of submarine incidents. Let's go into that. And yeah, we will first simply check out those missions. I won't play that much. This is locked for NATO, but you will also, if you're interested in Soviet play, I'm pretty sure there will be also some Soviet action. Yeah, briefings. Especially for our first mission, it could be a bit more detailed on the background, on the political situation. That was really great in Northern Fury. The first scenario of Northern Fury, really great. Good, yeah, we are in the interface here. Let's go full screen. And you see we are only in command of a couple of submarines. Let's set the map settings. It's some time since I played it. But mission areas, I usually use only selected missions. And of course we want to get our 3D tech view money worth. Message log separate. And let's set it up in order to feel home. To feel like at home. Good. So we have the F-300 Oslo Narvik guided missile frigate here. And the Falagut. Okay. Yeah, I think I will play this. So there's not more to check out. We'll simply see what happens. Let's check out the other scenarios. Kobayashi Maru. So you will have attacks on American carrier battle groups, like in what is the book called here by Tom Clancy? I read it long ago. Red Storm Rising, of course. Yeah, attacking by the BSNC. The second scenario is, for example, reserved for the Soviet Union. So you will see both. And this looks way more, I guess this is already escalation moment. Of course we can declutter that. Most declutter will happen by showing range rings only for selected units. Yeah. The Mediterranean. That is interesting. Carrier attack in the Mediterranean. Usually it's happening somewhere here. Quite a unique one. Yeah, what systems do we have? What is even the year currently? 85, okay. So the escalation here is happening in 85. I think there's also Northern Fury, not sure what's Northern Fury happening in the 90s. Was basically going for a late escalation, most focused on 85. I think Northern Fury's story followed a late escalation of the Cold War. Basically assumed that the Soviet Union didn't break up that early, or was a bit more formidable, powerful. Yeah, a lot of submarines here. Charlie 2 pictures. Yeah, I didn't install the newest picture pack. My pictures are 1 year old. So if some are missing, okay, that's unidentified. We might need to download the newest picture pack from this Warfare Sims page. But seems like everybody is coming with a picture here. Helix, ASW, Helos. And this scenario is about nuking an aircraft carrier. Yeah, that is the prime prize in command. I did it once and it is really hard. I think it was even in Northern Fury. Attacking aircraft carriers is probably, in aerial naval warfare, is probably the most challenging task. Aircraft carrier is a prime prize. It is protected by everything an enemy fleet can bring up. And you really need to saturate it. Yeah, that was also the Soviets' plan for extreme saturation attacks, meaning simply fire a lot of weapon systems in order to overwhelm enemy defense systems to the maximum. Otherwise you can't penetrate and get a hit on a carrier. Good. So the second is in the Mediterranean. Let's check out what is the third about. What happened to life? Really enjoyed life. I hope they will continue with the life series. I mean, there's new conflicts sparkling. I guess they won't break out, but could do a what-if situation. So in Asia. Yeah, if you care for spoilers, I recommend you not to read the descriptions and look away, as you're basically already proceeding through the campaign. Perhaps I will spare out endgame and those things. I just want to get a feeling, give you a feeling for the assets you will operate. I'm also not myself reading the briefings. But what I can tell is that the briefings are, again, yeah, let's say quite basic. Yeah, it is of course a matter of taste. Some people say I don't care for that, but I know many players that care for immersion. Immersion can be created by even something little like adding some sentences. Especially if the entire world is going to war. For me, it is very interesting what is happening in the world. What is the lore? Northern Fury was especially in the beginning strong on that. Yeah, we played a scenario where the US is under attack. There's not much happening gameplay-wise. There's not much happening, but the scenario was one of the best I've ever played. Just because of the immersion. What with those event messages and everything. Perhaps you get event messages in the scenarios, but the briefings themselves. Yeah, pretty basic, even for military standards. Yeah, briefings. Yeah, okay. But if you don't care for that, I guess. Good, yeah, that is a classic theater for World War III. Here, the geo gap, which was heavily protected, yeah. Because the Soviets might want to seize that. Jan Mayen Island. Is that small thing here, right? Or was it somewhere here? And yeah, the Sozos barrier, in order to prevent the influx of Soviet submarines in the Atlantic. Old story, yeah. World War I, World War II. If you want to cut off the European theater and Britain, cut off the supply routes. That was also, of course, the plan of the Soviets to hit the Atlantic hard and Atlantic hard in order to cut off the European theater in order to have an easy advance on the mainland. Yeah, Norway would, of course, also become an important AO as it is here. Classic Cold War gone hot scenario. The defense of Norway. As Norway would, of course, enable the Soviets also a further staging point. Naval, aerial, you always need to keep in mind, you can bring your bombers forward, your fighters forward, and operate against naval targets and against mainland targets. Good. Makes sense, right? Let's check out the next scenario. What was that, firecrackers? I mean, I will now do something. I will give you an impression of the briefing, but if you don't want to see that, look away. And then we might do one more. I'm not reading it myself. Gibraltar, North Atlantic. Let's check out North Atlantic. Classic Cold War, naval engagements. What is going on there? And then we will play. I don't think it makes too much sense to check out all scenarios. You get the quantity, you get the idea. Yeah, that is also in the vicinity of the Geok Gap. Searching for enemy submarines especially. That would be also typically US or Allied submarines would deploy into this seas in order to disrupt enemy shipment and especially submarines. And of course also the major Soviet fleet elements. We have British elements here, Sea Lion. That is a... What is that for a submarine? Canada, okay. Yeah, sure, they will join in. That I think is, yeah, the Dutch. British. So, quite multinational here, quite diverse. With some surface task groups and some radar installations operating from Britain and Norway. Okay, now let's play the campaign. As if we would do a real playthrough, and I will start a campaign mode. So, yeah, we already talked about that. What if between NATO and Warsaw Pact forces in 85? A follow-on from Northern Inferno 75. But Northern Inferno was 75. Ah, okay, I mixed something up. Yeah, to clarify that. This campaign follows the official Northern Inferno DLC. This one here. I mixed it up with Northern Fury. Northern Fury is a community project, which is depicting, it's also great, depicting a campaign, a global war escalation, also somewhere 85 to 90s. However, this campaign is following Northern Inferno was focusing on a 75 World War III situation. Yeah. And Red Tide is focusing on this 85 apex. Yeah, 75, 85 sounds like only 10 years. Nowadays, 10 years don't make that much big difference, probably for some of you. But between 75 and 85, there was another climax of weapon development. Yeah, both major powers invested into new weapon systems, which hit the theaters. So it's quite a difference. In all, yeah, air, land, and sea. Okay, yeah, because they all carry the name Northern. So it's basically, you could play those two games in an epic campaign. The Northern Inferno DLC and then play the Red Tide DLC. Which doesn't make that much sense because, spoilers ahead, you will start to nuke everybody in Northern Inferno. At least on a tactical nukes. I don't think you're going for strategic nukes, but tactical nuking is often a warm welcome for strategic nuking. While I could imagine that this focuses more on a conventional confrontation, which was very likely if both states would have went to a war on Central Europe or European mainland. They wouldn't immediately launch nuclear weapons because of the MRD doctrine both run that if you launch, the counter-launch will kill you. If you try to attack strategic, you will get murdered by it as well. Yeah. Mutual assured destruction, which probably protected us from getting nuked. But who knows how the story will turn out. Because another dilemma was if one of both major powers would be pressed too hard, of course they would use the strategic arsenal. So if ever World War III would have gone hot, you could imagine a possibility would be a limited warfare, for example for Europe, which wouldn't have lasted too long. It's also basically what you read in those techno thrillers by Tom Clancy and others. Okay, yeah. Could the campaign briefing is a bit sounding like an ad. I would have wished for more information on what is going on. But okay, perhaps the first briefing. Yeah, Jimmy's, that is not a briefing. For WhatsApp sentence. Okay, but let's roll. So we are the USS Bedford, or in command of the USS Bedford. US 2nd Fleet Destroyer patrol near Svalbard Islands together with the Narvik. And we getting repeatedly overflown by Soviet aircraft. In naval terms, getting overflown by aircraft is quite an aggressive move. That is something you don't do. Yeah? That is, in naval standards, getting or overflying ships is considered a very bold, very aggressive move, very unfriendly. Yeah, including low-level passes at main deck level. Yeah, that is even more unfriendly. That is really trying to intimidate you, yeah. So we are already on high tensions. It seems if the Soviet pilots are going in for that, that is already, we are here already in psychological warfare territory. And we have a fleeting contact on Zona, which is believed to be unknown submarine in territorial waters. Hostilities are not broken out. That is I love the moment when in those Cold War games or whatever, when everything is fine and then it goes to the hell. That is the best. Yeah, let's roll. Okay. Okay, now we get a proper briefing, but again, yeah, I already talked about this. think the initial story, that's basically two sentences. We already had better briefings beforehand. This, for example, Science Service, which also had graphically nicely done briefings. So more a bit of devolution. But okay, at least I gained my information. We have a detachment at Banach of P-3 Orion ASW aircraft and two surface ships, I guess with towed arrays and helos, which can assist in ASW search attempts. And we assume that the submarine is en route to rendezvous with a submarine support ship. So we also need to check the surface ships if there is a suspicious surface ship that might be supplying submarines. And it seems like we are shadowed by a Soviet reconnaissance aircraft. And we need to watch out with transmission. MCON is not officially limited or tagged, but we're not supposed to transmit without reason. Okay. Good. Game is currently paused. Let's see. This is what I need. Do I ever use this here? I think I know. You don't know. Let's get more screen. Let's get my 3D. Get my separate. Yeah, I will read the chat any second. Yeah, raw text is always good for me. Hi, Smart. I found a World War II enemy Man of War demo. Man of War demo. World War One. The only command game I played was Harpoon. What? HQ for DOS. HQ for DOS. I don't know HQ. I was thinking first we're talking about Harpoon, which is basically a spiritual, or command is somewhat the spiritual successor of Harpoon. Or is HQ something different? Good, okay. Where's my P3s? Here. Nah. Wasn't it some island? Yeah, Banach is here. Okay, those guys will take some time to arrive into the AO. Do we have any mission settings right now? Yeah, we have. Okay. We have patrol areas already defined. Those guys are assigned to those patrol areas. So I guess there's a good reason why they do that. I won't change that. What we might do is we will start to launch helos, but it seems like those destroyers or frigates don't carry helos. I mean, I see a... No, yeah, he's not carrying a helo. Okay, and this guy, that looks like a helo, hey, but he's not carrying a helo. Perhaps, oh, maybe it's a destroyer. I was hoping for helos, but no. So we need to do it here with those destroyers. I don't have any area assets right now. We will immediately launch the P3s from Banach. We have two available. One is ready in 4 hours. I will immediately launch two. We could keep one in reserve. No. P3 Orients have airtime that is very impressive. Typical modern turboprop aircraft. He is loaded with... How many torpedoes is he carrying? Eight, that is enough. He's also carrying a harpoon, just in case. Good, yeah, I will send him probably to the ASW patrol area as well. No need to design a specific mission for them. Assign to mission ASW patrol area and launch them. Immediately. We'll launch them individually, no need to go in groups. That is absolutely not helpful with ASW aircraft. What you can do is specify the areas. Because the Zonobuoy AI in command is, perhaps they improved it. Yeah, but it's difficult. Yeah, normally you would deploy Sono buoys. They sometimes randomize it. Yeah? You can somewhat do it with mission area. We will see. They will take some time to arrive in the mission in the AO anyways. And then I can change plans. Yeah, about sensors. Currently we're running sensor, no sensors. Yeah, not sure if I like that. I mean, we can run a couple of minutes passive, but I might want to go for active pinging at least. Below the water, yeah, using active sonar, which would be here. The SQ-8-16 is currently not operating. Because a ship passive sonar never can compete with a submarine sonar. Is the turret array at least streamed? Oh, those guys even have a turret array. Jimmy, no turret array for you? Okay, goddammit. So he's using hull sonar. Hull sonar is 4 bar on surface ships compared to submarine sonars or turret arrays, especially. Yeah, I don't see any on any turret array or sinking array. What is the? Is there a thermal layer? Yeah, I can't check for that right now. Okay, whatever. We will take it. I will run the game in real time, and then we will see what is going on here. Somebody picked up a submarine. What we perhaps want to check out is the message log settings. Always make sure, but I think they defaulted it now, that special messages raise a pop-up. Yeah, I think that is default. Otherwise you might miss important information. What I want to know, the Oslo was built when? 85, that is fresh from the staple. Jimmy, no turret array? 85? No, it doesn't seem like. And the Fallagut was built in, yeah, it's also a quite new system. ECM, offensive ECM, active passive full sonar, no turret array. Okay. Good, yeah, we will handle that. Let's start the game. Okay, hier Aircraft launching. Check it out. Yeah, our P3s are en route. This will take some time. We might need to use acceleration. Second P3 is also ready for ASW operations, anti-submarine warfare. Question now is if we are basically riding currently completely blind. Yeah, second P3 is launching. Departed Banak en route to the AO. With the hull sonars, we won't pick up that submarine. However, if we go active, we might tip off the submarine that we know that in the area. I'm also not happy about having my air radar deactivated. If we have incoming missiles or whatever, we'll pick up them lately. Very late. I might go active on some of the sensors. Especially air search. Yeah, ECM you usually don't enable in peacetime. Yeah, passive sensors you don't need to activate, they're always active. I will go active. Yeah, you can also simply use this here. Okay, we're activating radars and sonars on the Bedford and also on the Narvik. I will keep the P3 Orions on because on dark I don't want anybody to know about the presence. So that is our air search radar, that is surface, that is sonar. But those active pings you can hear it. You might even a submarine from here could hear that somebody is active pinging. It is really loud. If you ever was, if you dived or if you used to diving operations, ever heard a ship active pinging, it is crazy how loud that is. It's also why in exercises, active pinging is somewhat restricted to, and if you need it, is even the maritime life is absolutely going crazy when you're active pinging. Can really damage, yeah, endure maritime life. So this is an extreme loud acoustic signal sent out in order to pick up reflections. I don't know, I don't kind of imagine what would happen if you would be a diver. For example, if you dive from a ship, the ship is not allowed to do active pinging. I don't know what whole thing. It could really blow you away, even if you're in your diving suit. Command HQ was really basic. Oh, okay. What was it about? Was it about naval warfare? I'm sometimes interested in retro games. Good, is there anything else to attend? Let's check the rules of engagement, weapon release. That was here. We are currently running global. No nuclear weapons allowed, too bad. Everything else. Nothing of interest. Good. P3s, yeah, this will take a lot of time. But Jimmy's coming in. Flying in formation. Yeah, let's speed up the game. Yeah, let's quickly check out those P3. MPA stands for Marine Patrol Aircraft. They, in 85, they should be already quite formidable. They run a radar, a camera, a search, a MRD, magnetic anomaly detector. Those things were for some time very strong in command, while in reality it was not that strong. But they will use sonar buoys. Sonar buoys are their primary weapon of detection. Okay, yeah, business as usual. One thing that might be interesting is our ships are carrying... Yeah, they're carrying sonar buoys. So I might drop a passive sonar buoy right now, shallow or deep. Let's quickly slow down. Depth here is 1,020 feet. No layer. Ah, here, you see there is information, no layer. Layers are thermal layers, which might interfere with the spread of the sound propagation. And layers play an important role in especially submarine warfare. But we have no layer here, but the water is quite deep. Here, not that deep. So the Bedford might launch a passive sonar buoy, a shallow one. And the Narvik might launch one deep in case we are trailed by something, because we don't have towed sonar rays. And you see the rear is not covered. There would be indeed a possibility to that somebody is in our baffles and we don't realize that. And furthermore, if we leave this area, we still have those sonar buoys that descend, but they have a cable that is going to the surface, and you can receive data information via, yeah, various wireless means. And I think they dropped them now, but you need to activate the vision. There's a sonar buoy setting on the map, which normally is ghosted. Okay, so we will see them. Perhaps this guy is not carrying sonar buoys. Whatever. Ah, wait, here, deploy dipping sonar. Oh, message. Okay, something is happening. Let's see what happened. Fishing boats have reported a large Soviet ship in position. Okay, let's mark that. 78, 41. Somewhere here. Good, we will send one ship in. Yeah, okay, it's already marked. Yeah, good, this means I might send a ship manually there. I guess the Narvik is close to respond. Is this passable here? We have a depth of 200-300 feet. Looks good. Give me a waypoint. Check out what is going on there. And do it fast. There are some suspicious Soviet ship there. He's changing course. And we might go on cruise. This will not help with... I mean, avoid cavitation. No, Jimmy. Otherwise we will arrive never. Let's cavitate. I need minimum 15 knots. Give me full 22 knots. This means that the active sonar and everything will not work out that great. Passive sonar is basically now blind at 22 knots, but I need to to see what is going on there. Good, ship is on the way. Ah, yeah, and those sonar boys are not dropping, so I guess those guys are not carrying them. No, doesn't seem like that those ships are carrying sonar boys. I mean, I can try again, but I guess they are not carrying. Yeah, the Bedford will also go in this area and then we can check out what's going on there. T3 is incoming. I might give them a manual. Yeah, but currently looks good. Waypoints look fine. So I think this is the vicinity I'm interested in right now. And I also might switch off the anti-cavitation setting on this ship. Otherwise, yeah, let's go cruise. I think 20 knots. Nah, creep is so slow. 15 knots is okay for search operations. Let's go 15 knots. Yeah, I really hope that they improved somewhat the submarine warfare aspect of command. I think that was the weak point of CMO. Especially if you play Northern Fury or whatever, it must blow up immediately. Insta detection. That is not really depicting how it would go in real life. They often acquire really precise target solutions instant. They should learn something from Zonalist combat simulations, which made fleet command and especially dangerous waters and sub command the best modern submarine sim beside CMO. Oh, Jimmy, pause, what is that? A skunk, okay, a surface ship. A skunk is the code for a surface ship. Slow down to 15 knots. Might be simply some civilian Tony enjoying himself. Boogie. Okay, we got something on the air radar. Nothing to write home about now. T3 Orions coming in. Yeah, might design a specific mission for them. And which I can, yeah, I might do that. Bit difficult here. Land masses, but the AI will be usually smart and not drop, for example, sonar boys on land. Yeah, I mean, the P3 won't run any active emissions anyways. We will drop sonar boys. So that is fine. I guess no need for this option. On station, yeah, you can go loiter. And in order to perform your MRD search, but MRD search is normally done for terminal confirmation before attack. I mentioned it, yeah, beforehand you could pick up all submarines, even sea wolves and whatever, and no matter how deep with MRD, that was absolutely a joke. But they changed that. There's also a reason why they're removing those MRD detectors from modern P3 systems and other ASW MPA aircraft. Because the combat value is not that high. Good, that is my new mission. And we will assign those P3s to that. Are they going already active while they're doing that? Jimmy, So I need to keep the setting. Is that set? I don't want to have active. What is he doing there? Is that, what is it for a search cone? Jimmy, don't run any radars. We don't need radars. No, Jimmy. Radars passive. Yes. Can also inherit. But you know what? Your sonars, your sonar boys, you can run active. That is fine. Yeah, but don't run radars. Okay. They deactivate the radars. The time didn't went on. Nobody should know about us. What's going on with my PC? Command. Okay, everything is fine. I don't know what happened here. Should be everything is fine. Right. Okay, we are live. I was thinking I'm about to explode. My PC suddenly started. I don't know what was going on. Perhaps the entire Soviet Navy okay. Okay, we are about to identify this. I mean, you can pull the waypoint a bit here for a nice intercept. Let's also a bit declutter the screen. I don't need to see those mission areas. So some new map options. Yeah, that is harpoon style. You can also play it harpoon style. That is... Wait, which map I always use? Was it... I think I used Sentinel, right? Or was it BMNG? Was it BMG again? That is classic command, exactly. But isn't Sentinel 2 way more interesting? Mike requires some time to become high resolution. Look at this, isn't that looking way better? load times are not the best. Okay. Okay, yeah, that is identified to be probably hostile. Intelligence gathering ship, Primordier. Okay. Tonys. Are you supplying any enemy submarines here in my bay? Go on interception course. We need to bring them up. He's trying to escape. Yeah, go. Fast. No way. What is he riding? 10 knots. Okay, we should intercept him by rule of thumb somewhere here. Yeah, that is... So... the P3s, P3s arriving. Well, okay, I guess we can handle that without them. The question is what I will do with it. I can't blow him up. We're not at war. But I can do a customs check. Check out. Check for COVID documents. Okay, there's some awesome reach of our land weapons. Okay, what happened? Fishing boats have reported a periscope in position 7918 north. Yeah, that is important. 78. Is it written down here somewhere? Okay, let's find it manually. 7918 is here. 3350 is here. Okay, memorize that quickly. 3350 7980. Good, Bedford, go immediately there. Periscope sighted. Full speed, and I send a... I go flank. Ah, that is not really a difference. And send a P3 immediately there as well. To conduct search. It will arrive in... Can I see information? It will arrive in 20 minutes. 20 minutes, that is a lot of time. He might be, of course, not on the position anymore. Yeah, but we could modify the search box for that immediately. Okay, P3 is coming in. P3, speed up, military. I need you immediately there. Is that landmass? No. Let's lock him in. In 20 minutes he can't make more distance like this. Well, if I would be a Soviet sub, I would either go for... start is here. Usually hit here. You come in from the south. And then start active pinging it. Good, yeah. And what is about the ship here? We are almost on collision course. But we are not at war. What I'm supposed to do is it. Fire at it. Fire warning shot. Yeah, let's intercept it first and see what we can do. Perhaps there's some event triggered or whatever. But if they're in international waters, what are you supposed to do? It is a ship. We can't nuke it. But we can't scare it away, yeah. Show forces. Some force comparison. Typical Cold War stuff. Jimmy! What are you doing here? Wait, I need to slow down the game. Otherwise I crash into him. We watching you. We are watching you. Niet, niet, niet! Civilian trawler. Just delivering fish, no problem. Spasiba, no. Davarish, no problem. Everything fine, just... Tony, I know what you're doing here. Well, he's shaking. Good, I think we can slow down a bit here. So let's assume, what is the enemy doing here? They were placing a supply ship in the vicinity of this area, which could probably that they, yeah, I guess they did some intelligence there on the harbors, and probably also on the naval activity, photographing everything, and probably supplying submarine with new orders and everything you need. Yeah, I guess the ship, there's no need to follow it. You can't do anything against it. I will still check out the Ah, it's night. Okay, good to know. I will still check out this area, not that they deployed something there, some Spetsnaz midget submarines or whatever. And yeah, this area is important. Could of course send in the Narvik as well. But two P3 Orions are inbound on max speed. Let's find a submarine. We also need to check the time. That was reported at Zulu time. 10:30. That is 1 hour ago. 10:40. Zulu is... Oh, Jimmy, how did you report it at... I guess I mixed it up with local time. That doesn't look to be Zulu time. Southwest, speed slow, southwest. That is here. Okay, yeah, let's take this intelligence into account and hit this area first, expand the area. He might be already way farther ahead than we are considering. Let's play it safe. Start searching right here. You know what, bring in the... Yeah, but I want to check out the bay, something, I don't trust this ship here, something they did there. Okay, starting to deploy sonar buoys. Okay, that looks great. But this MPA should start right here from the and commands to the north. Hope the AI will do that. Yeah, he's going low altitude. Normally you wouldn't fly a P3 like that. That would be an absolute crazy angle. But okay, Tony, do it. We covering the south with Sono boys. I want to cover this here especially. I will already drop a Sono boy passive. What is the def here? Def 630, drop shallow. Jimmy, are you? Tony, can you handle it? What is he doing? Perhaps leave him alone. Oh, it's this goddamn general calling over the radio tank. Fly 5 degrees left, fly 5 degrees right. It's only stressing him out. Yeah, we'll drop some manual Sono boys. When this guy is he assigned to the mission? Yeah, let's assign him again. Might set him to ignore waypoints. Good, yeah, two destroyers coming in. Yeah, you run 15 knots, it's a bit slow. Run to this position with, and then commence search. And because this submarine did this trawler did something there. And my impression of the situation is that the Soviets trying to gather intelligence on this situation and also park submarines for a potential alpha strike against shipment and land installations. That's when you would like to deploy submarines here, yeah, in order to gather intelligence on fleet activity, but also to fire in case of war against land installations. This Tony is getting out of here as he would. Has he done his mission? Yeah, he's somehow. But I'm done here. So let's check this area out. How much Sono boys are you carrying? 97, Tony. Yeah, don't be. I know they cost a lot of money. I think one Sono boy is costing. I read some. A modern Sono boy is costing. What was it? But it is several thousand dollars. Okay, he's starting to deploy them. One of those things, and you need to imagine, in submarine hunting, 95% of Sono boys are dropped are pointless. But that's how the system works. But they cost us several thousand dollars. I guess, especially in 85. Let's confirm the. Is that really the position we're looking for? 7918 north. 7918 north. 3350 east. 33. Yeah, that is the position we're looking for. Good. The submarine must be somewhere here. Here, probably this message was transmitted on Zulu 1030, and you also need to keep into you need to keep in take it into account that something that is transmitted to you doesn't mean that it really was observed at this time. So we let's add 1 hour plus. This means the submarine would have 2 hours to maneuver. I might expand the area even further. But we might take the intelligence into account that the fisherman reported that he's heading southwest. Which is not a safe. Oh! We gained the submarine. What is that? No, that's a submarine. Is it really civilian? Yeah, it is. Mark one eyeball by the pilots. I guess it is civilian. You wouldn't mistake a submarine with a civilian ship. Jimmy, watch out that this submarine is not escaping already. Can you deploy sonobots area? The swivel incoming and check the center. He's running flank speed. Hi, have you seen a movie? What movie? I'm not familiar with this game. Can you command ground force or only naval or air force? Yeah, you can ask command ground force in command, but at this state, I wouldn't say that ground force are really the priority of this game. Ground warfare is rather abstracted, which also makes sense because like ground warfare requires on the operational level a lot of detail, and now you can command ground force, no doubt, but I would say this game is focusing on air and naval operational warfare. Okay, the ship is an identified commercial fishing boat. Perhaps that is a boat that reported the enemy submarine. It's very abstracted, yeah. It's basically two battalions fighting each other with some sort of health points. But you don't play command modern operations for the ground combat. You play it for naval and aerial warfare on an operational scale. Good. He deployed a nice screen there, but I still want to cover the south screen, the south. As this was reported by the fishing boat, while this Tony, yeah, he can continue and drop his sonar boys into the center. Jimmy, you should have dropped one here. That was. He might be already out of the area. Ah, he's dropping, okay. The Bedford incident, okay. No, I didn't see the movie. And to be honest, I never heard of this movie. It's a dedicated movie on this incident. I can't even tell. Is this a historical incident? That there was a submarine brought up in this area. Okay, we have a nice western screen. But if the submarine is already out of this area, we might waste... I need to... Perhaps I need to expand... Yeah, Jimmy, at least cover this port here. Jimmy, come over here. I have the feeling that the submarine already escaped our... our net. Our trap. Don't let him enter. I was mentioning in a Slytherin Tea Time stream that first say that they have plans of increasing the fidelity of ground combat. Yeah, that would be a nice step up for command to become a all aspect operational warfare simulator. I already read that, yeah, that I mean those guys basically know themselves that ground combat is abstracted. And there's nothing really on the market. There's no real-time operational ground combat war game. There were some attempts, and of course some are used by the military, like for example in Germany by Zila. When you hit officer training. But it is not a video game. It is not like you're sitting on a PC and fighting it out alone. Officer training is handled usually that you work in a group together with computer assistants, war game assistants, but a lot of stuff is done. It's not like you're playing single-handedly a video game. And this is often as commenced. Yeah. You have a ton of hex-based terms, but real-time ground warfare, operation ground warfare. That is definitely not there at the moment. So and would expand in this direction, they would definitely profit. Many software is already in use by, for example, the German Luftwaffe and German Marine, German naval forces. At least a professional edition, but there's not that much difference between those two versions. That has more to do with the functionality on the metagaming, like setting up a server, having observers, having moderators or game masters. It was a fictional movie in the 60s. Well, interesting, I don't know about this movie. Might need to check it out. Nice. Because I like movies like that, but never heard of the Bedford Incident as a movie. Jimmy, drop your goddamn... Why are you leaving this gap here, you goddamn... If a submarine is silent running, he might slip through the... What is that? Give me a alloy. Yeah, I don't have time for that. Drop simply the Sono Boy in the center. Get out. What's the reason for that? Well, Jimmy, I want to eat my sandwich. Ah, it is out of the area. Okay, yeah, it makes sense. Yeah, you see, this is basically out of the mission area, and then he stops to deploy. Okay, it makes sense. Okay, I'm currently not picking it up. But we have the entrance secured, but who knows, perhaps the submarine is already in the entrance. That's why I'm sending the Narvik into the report location of the Soviet supposedly Soviet supply ship. Because perhaps he supplied a submarine there. Oh, what was that? Okay, we picked up our aircraft. Which probably is now transmitting and getting information. But why we are picking it up? Is he transmitting on radar? The ANSPS 37 is what? Yeah. Could be that he was simply picked up by a regular radar, not by a radar warning receiver. What is it? Boogie. Okay. That's something bigger. Yes, stop running on this high speed, go to cruise, and now go to 15 knots in order to aid with a hull active and passive sonar. Let's see, this area is not covered, but fishermen report that they are heading to the west. Could be that they changed their plans. Yeah, what I noticed is that, I mean, I think this feature is already in place for a couple of months, a couple of versions. But once those MPAs, yeah, your P3s or helos, hit the AO, which you designate for anti-submarine warfare operations, by designing waypoints, they will still drop their sonobuoys, so you can design your own sonobuoy nets. The AI drops it rather randomly, as you see. So this allows you to do it properly. I think that is a perfect solution. Perfect solution, really good feature. Okay, yeah, the Western approach is covered. Could be that this fisherman saw a dolphin and was thinking it is a periscope, and we dropped several 100k worth of sonobuoys, taxpayer money, for no good, but that's warfare, yeah. 95% of ordnance that is dropped in modern warfare is it's thin air. But the other 5%, that's what matters. Yeah, we have the civilian commercial fishing ship, which I guess was the guy that gave us information on the periscope. Let's quickly check what is the space between two sonobuoys. Where's the range tool? Control D. Yeah, 4 nautical miles should be fine. I mean, sure, if the Soviets bring up the most modern submarines, but they don't have a layer here, it would be rather very challenging to get a sub through this sonobuoy net without being noticed. So either there is no sub, or we need to wait. Where's the second MPA? The only one. Ah, here. Perhaps check this area out. Yeah, he's running 15 knots. You know what? Check this area out. And this Tony is still... it could also speed up. Let's speed up to this waypoint. And then commence a proper search by hull sonar. What? Boogie? Yeah, Boogie is an aircraft target. This is the one that is shadowing us, and probably a ELINT aircraft that is gathering information on our activity there. Also, sometimes what you do in warfare, in operational warfare, is simply try to... We found somebody. Okay. We got a Goblin. Goblin is the designation for a post-sub. We have a post-sub. Jimmy, we found him. Good, let's first mark this position. Okay, we have a post-sub here. I will limit now my search area to this in order to bring everybody in. But seems like we have a post up here. I will bring in my P3s, which will require some time to come in. You can speed up. Some Jimmy. What the heck was that? Jimmy! Did you launch up? Why is he launching up? Tony! He's launching a harpoon as he surfaced or what? Tony! Jimmy, stop launching those harpoons, goddammit. That's how World War 3 started. Why has he a weapon release authorization on that? He's firing on that sub. It could be that he surfaced for some reason. Tony, take it easy. That is an unidentified goblin. Why are you launching harpoons? God damn it. Yeah, that's how World War 3 started. The US firing on everything. God damn it. Yeah, two weapons allocated to the goblin. I guess he surfaced. Seems like the P3 Orions picked up a lock. I don't know why they're launching on it. Again, I need to check out the WRA. Tight, tight, tight. Jimmy, that doesn't look to me to be too tight. Anti-submarine warfare. Why are they launching harpoons on a goblin? That is quite aggressive, yeah. Just to mention it. Normally you might bring up the submarine with test depth charges or training depth charges in order to signal the submarine that we located you, stop your operations. We know what you are, what you're trying, get away from here. For this you would use training depth charges. However, a submarine can't tell if you're firing test depth charges or re-depth charges. For example, something that happened in the Cuba Missile Crisis. The destroyers were dropping training depth charges on Soviet submarines, which felt endangered and were considering the launch of tactical nuclear torpedoes. Yeah, Jimmy, I don't know. What the heck, why are my P3 Orions launching harpoons? Let me again visit the screen. Weapon controls air tight. Fire only at contacts position. Yeah, but that is not hostile. Who the heck told you to fire those harpoons on every goblin contact? What is the authorization for harpoons? Yeah, that's how World War 3 started. They immediately fired harpoons. Timmy, that is quite arc though. Yeah, we're running pessimistic, which means we won't fire on if you're not sure that it's enemy. What the heck? Subsurface tight. Fire only at contacts positively identified as hostile. Jimmy, you're firing at those guys. Are those P3 running different? No, I guess not. I want to see World War 3 happening. Yeah, that is surprising that those P3s engaging It seems like the submarine surfaced, was picked up by ground radar, and they're engaging them. Could be have something to do with the mission. Ah, here! Subsurface is free, why? God damn it. Why was it free? Can you stop the guidance on those weapons? I don't want to start World War III. Jimmy, stop it! This will cause... Tony, no! How can I stop this attack? Drop targets! Yeah, that's exactly how World War III happens. There's one unit that didn't got the proper orders and suddenly it happens. No, wait, Jimmy, stop guiding them. Let's get them out of RadarCon. But here, he's running a 360 RadarCon. I can't stop those harpoons anymore. Perhaps they do. They did it on purpose, to see if a player will notice that one of those missions will come as a weapons free, because orders were transmitted wrong. Oh no, I hope this guy is submerged, but he was still treated as a hostile intent. Will definitely not help the peace efforts, but those things are guiding, yeah, they still have a target. Oh no, Tony, two harpoons incoming. We are Davarish. We want to negotiate peace forever. Let's stop Cold War. That is a peace submarine, and I just fired two harpoons on it. I also put something like 1 minute. If the submarine is surfaced, and that's kids, that is how World War III started. Some commander, some hardliner. Oh shit, that doesn't sound good. That sounds like an impact. Oh shit, that was an impact. I don't think that... Yeah. We sunk a submarine. Oh, Tony. Oh. How do I explain that? Commander. We are in peacetime. Why did you engage the enemy's Soviet submarine with harpoon missiles? Tony, I gave out those orders. I don't know why those P-3 Orions engaged them. Yeah. We sunk a submarine. That is quite a hostile intent. Second, the harpoon is passing. Flash, flash, flash. Oh, okay, we need to read that message. It is a flash, flash, flash message. To all units, Goblin assessed as Cat 4 sunk. Yeah. That was the first war activity. How did this... Why was my P3 Orion mission not weapons tagged? forgot to inherit the mission settings, I guess. Yeah, we'll see how fast it goes, yeah. Yeah, Jimmy's, we now need to consider this aggress incoming. Do I need to consider it hostile? He's coming close. Do we want to start World War III? Hardliner? Let's start World War III. Aircraft is considered hostile. This showing a direct path on our destroyer, which can be considered to be an hostile intent and a bombing run, we consider it hostile fire. Rim is on the way. That's, I like it. Yeah, first and all, pretty good. And we're firing our anti-aircraft missile against whatever is incoming there. Could be as a civilian airliner. Missile will impact in 10 seconds. Shot down. I start World War III. Yeah, you know, I'm a hardliner general. Yeah, I experienced World War II, and I was always thinking those Soviets, they are suspicious. I only drinking distilled water because I'm always in fear that the Soviets might poison the water system of the US. Somehow I went crazy and decided to start World War III. Here we shot down the reconnaissance aircraft. Guess the Soviets won't be that happy about that. One of the best naval war films. Yeah, we'll definitely check it out if you say it is pretty good. Bedford Incident. Wait, oh, I forget it. I need to check it out. Bedford Incident movie. Oh, yeah, I never saw this movie. Nice mentioning, great. '65 movie. Interesting, I need to see it. Yeah, we sunk a submarine. And I think it was even a ballistic submarine. That is even worse. And we simply shot down a reconnaissance aircraft by the Soviets will definitely help on a peace table. Yeah, wonder what happens if you play peacefully. We basically had an incident. It was by accident that my Orions sunk the surfaced enemy submarine. I don't know even what we sunk there. And then I went all in. I mean, we can check it out what we sunk there. A Golf 2 class. Okay. Yeah, and you can imagine what will happen next. This might be the turning point for the Cold War. Some troop commander, rogue troop commander, decided to simply splash them away. And the Soviets might now retaliate, and it will result in global World War III. So, yeah, this was Command Red Tide Campaign Expansion. Check it out. If you buy it on Matrix, you usually also receive a Steam key. If you buy it on Steam, business as usual. And yeah, at least when it comes to the ASW operations, I really like it that you can control your aircraft, how you want to drop the sonar buoys. And in my opinion, despite Dangerous Waters, Command is still the best modern surface and submarine warfare simulator.